step, you were with us, kneeling on this battle ground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing that for every step, Papa, we're in us. The stars and struggles on the way, but with joys our hearts can share. Yes, our hearts can share. The stars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can share. Yes, our hearts can share.
Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. 'Cause you are faithful, God, you are faithful. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own.
Up, looking just how far we've come, knowing that for every step you were with us, kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing that for every step you were with us. Stars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can share. Our hearts can say, stars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, yes, our hearts can say. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once leave us on our own. You are faithful, God, you are faithful. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. 'Cause you are faithful, God, you are faithful.
Praise the Lord. Yeah. You know, God doesn't just have one generation of daft people. 1973, my family and I were daft people as well. We went out to Macau in Southeast China with only £70 pledged to us. We needed £800. But we went because we heard the word of God, and hearing the word of God in a church that said, if you will go, if you will enter in the portal, enter through the door, I will be there. We went. 15 years later, we came home. And you know, you don't have to be daft. You just have to obey God and do what God wants you to do. And as you do that, so He will be behind you. He will be with you. Take that as just an encouragement from the Lord this evening, that He is with you. He'll not leave you without. He never left us without. And He won't leave you without. Okay? Because He's there. Enter through that gate. And as you do, his supply will be with you. Yeah. It'll be there. No matter how much you got here, we only had the airfare. That was it. But God met the needs, so be encouraged with that. That wasn't part of my message. It was just something I just felt led to share with you, because that was our experience. My wife and I in 71 with a little boy. We had a young boy of 4.5 years of age. So it was great. It was good to be there. I want to tell you a little story. It's a true story. This story will lead into what I want to share with you tonight from Luke chapter 5. Just briefly, I'm not going to spend a lot of time this evening. There isn't the time to share everything, but it's a funny story that actually happened, and it happened in Macau, Southeast China. My son and I, the whole family, used to like to walk the seawall around the Macau harbour. And one day, my son Robin and I, along with my wife, decided that we would try a little bit of fishing. So we took our rods and all that we needed, cast out the line, and I succeeded in doing was catching rocks. That's all I could catch, was rocks. So after several goes of trying to cast out the line to try and get something on the end, I finally tried once more, and then we would go home. Well, I got plenty of line ready to cast it out and started to into the process, and all of a sudden I found I wasn't going anywhere with it. Why? Because it got wrapped around the telephone wires over the top. There it was. No more. No way could I get it down. So I cut the wire, or cut the line, and went off home feeling quite foolish. And I never lived it down, because I was the laughing stock of my family. They laughed about that, and they would always rib me about it. And the line, as far as I know today, is still wrapped around the telephone wires there in the harbour of Macau, Southeast China. But there are those who make fishing their business, and their catch is their livelihood. And one day, the Lord was teaching, as we are told in Luke chapter 5, he was teaching the people. But because they were crowding around him, he got into the boat belonging to Simon Peter and told him to put out from the shore a little way so that he could teach more effectively. The reason he did this was that the people were wanting to hear the word of God. And after Jesus had taught them, he said to Peter, "Launch out into the deeper water and let your nets down." Well, Peter knew his fishing, and it was his trade. And what he wanted, what Jesus wanted him to do, was right out of the question. Because, you know, you put your nets down on one side of the boat only. But Jesus was asking him to do the opposite. He was asking him to cast the net on the wrong side of the boat. And that is what Peter said. That after that, I can almost hear him. Simon Peter answered, and in a sense argued with the Lord, "Lord, we've been here all night. We've been at it all night and we caught nothing. And you ask us, what you're asking us to do now is impossible. It's not possible to do that. It really won't work. At times we can go in... Oh, sorry, I've got ahead of myself. How many of us have argued with the Lord? Over something he has told us to do. Because for some reason we felt that it was really unreasonable. Well, I know, for example, that I have argued with the Lord. Because I felt what the Lord was asking me to do was the most impractical, the most impossible thing for us to do as a family. It wasn't just me, my wife also argued with the Lord for 6 months. We argued and we argued with him. It's not possible. It's just not going to work. What you're asking us to do, it's just ridiculous, Lord. It's not possible. And it almost cost us the partnership of two churches. You see, we've been talking about partnership. This whole conference has been about partnership. Coming alongside, or some people coming alongside of us, or we going alongside people to help them. At this particular time, we were in Taiwan, the Republic of China. And I think we were a little bit like Peter. The Lord told us to do something. And we felt that this was not possible. He told us to up our support to a missionary family in France. We were supporting them monthly, and the Lord said to us, no, up it, raise it. Raise your support to those missionaries. That's what we struggled about. That's what we argued about. We're just about making ends meet. And so we told the Lord it would not be possible for us to do what he wanted. But the Lord persisted. You know, when he says something, it just goes on and he goes on and he goes on and he goes on. Well, I don't like to say this, but it could be a little bit like my wife. She just goes on until she gets her way.
This is recorded, John.
Erase that. But, you know, the Lord just went on and on and on. And he bugged us so much about this. And I couldn't, I felt like Peter. The Lord said, Peter, put your net this side. Peter was going, no, Lord, that's not right. It's impossible. You can't do that. But the Lord, I guess, just kept on and on and on to him. Peter, in the end, obeyed the Lord. Did what the Lord wanted. And worked with the Lord and not against him. And we decided that, well, the time has come. All against the odds, perhaps if we had better do what the Lord wants us to do. You know, the question mark was still there. Perhaps we will do it. But what if we do? What will happen to us? If we do what raise the money to another missionary, friends of ours, so that they got out of trouble, Lord, what are we going to do? We're going to be in deeper trouble. Now, Peter was a skilled fisherman. And maybe it felt just as foolish to him to put the net down on the other side of the boat. But if he did, what would happen? What would happen to him? Or to what the Lord was asking him to do? I can almost hear Peter arguing just the point with the Lord. No, 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 this is wrong. But in the end, maybe he thought, what would happen if I actually did this? If I obeyed the Lord and did the impossible thing? We too wonder what would happen if we did what the Lord wanted us to do? The situation was impossible, but what will happen? What will happen? If we do this, what will happen to us? Our son Robin's fees in Taiwan, in the school that he was attending, was started off at 1,000 Taiwan dollars a year. By the time he got to senior, to I think it was the one before senior high, before he got there, the fees went up to 2,500 a year. And we thought, we can't pay this. We couldn't have that much money. How can you allow that? And if we didn't pay it, he would be banned from school. He wouldn't be able to go to school anymore until we paid it. What can you do on £800 a month to live on? How could you possibly pay that amount of money for his school fees? This was our argument. And in the end, against all the odds, decided to do what the Lord wanted us to do. We'd written home, asking people, telling the people the need, but that didn't work. Somehow that just didn't work. So we said, okay, Lord, we'll raise our support to these missionaries. So we wrote home to our mission headquarters. I'm not just IGO, I wear a second hat. I have two hats. I belong to an organization called Christians in Action. And I wrote home to them and told them we want to raise our support to this missionary family. And they said, okay, we'll do it. And so the very next month, that money was less in our pay packet. Now, coming back to Peter, he did what the Lord said for him to do. And the result, the catch was so great, they had to call others to come and help them to land the fish. Why? Because he obeyed his obedience, he received the partnership of his fellow fishermen, and everyone benefited from it. Everyone. He had partners come. The scriptures tell us that. That he called the other boats and they became partners to get the fish in. They all benefited, not just Peter, but everybody benefited from it. And when we obeyed the Lord, the month the missionary family received the amount of support that they needed, the Lord caused two churches, one in Newton Aycliffe, one in Southampton, to send us Robin's school fees for the next year until the next. The moment we partnered with the missionary family, to meet their need, the Lord blessed us with two partners. For just one partnering with one family, the Lord sent us double the amount. You know, and that, we've heard last night, partnership is essential. And when we learn to partner with others, the Lord partners with us and also causes others to come alongside of us to share in the load and to lighten the burden we may be bearing. We've heard so much to do with mission. So much to do with mission. We're all busy in our own ministries. But perhaps we have never thought about having a partnership experience with others around us. We learned very quickly, don't argue with the Lord. Just do what the Lord wants you to do. What he asks you to do. And you will find out that he will bring the help. And he will bring people to be in partnership with us. For us, it was until Robert, my son, graduated from senior high school in 1998. When we came home later that year, the partnership ended. The need was met. He was put through school. The burden was lifted. We were set free from a huge amount of debt that could have come, and he was saved from being banned from school because we couldn't pay those fees. But the Lord paid them through someone, through these two churches that came alongside. And I'm so glad that God does that. I'm so glad that God steps into our situations and he comes along. He is our mate. He is our chief partner. We partner him and he works through us. Remember, he's the head pastor. He's the head partner. He's the one that causes it all to happen. And we have found that when people come alongside to help in some way, we need to accept that help. Not turn it away, but to accept it. Because that is partnership. That is partnering. Together, doing what God wants us to do in partnership with each other. You know, we need each other. We do. I need you. Well, sorry, but you need me. It's like that. That's how it works. So let's stand with someone and see what we can do for each other. And as we partnership with each other this evening, God will surely bless. First thing I want you to do before we take up the offering is I want to ask you to pray with me. Not here necessarily, but on the 18th of October, I will be heading back to Ghana. Coming back home, arriving back home in Manchester on the 1st of November. So I have 2 full weeks over there. A very, very, very busy time. I think the busiest I've ever had in the 15 years that I've been going over there. And I think this is something like about my 32nd, 33rd visit to the place. But pray. Pray with me that God will do what he wants to do. I made a pledge to them over there, to the team that I'll be going over to work with, that I would pray every day that God's presence would be with us that whole 2 weeks. Every venue that I go to, that God's presence would be there. If his presence isn't going to be there, I don't want to go. I don't want to know. Even I've asked the Lord to be on the plane, to make his presence very real on that plane, because I hate flying. I hate every second of it. I'm glad when I get there, and I'm glad when I get back home again. But I've asked for the Lord's presence. Pray with us. Pray with me. Pray with the team over there that God's presence will be really, very real in our midst as we do what he wants us to do. And I would value that you would partner with me in doing that, and that you would pray, perhaps not every day, but perhaps doing some time in that week, those 2 weeks, that you would pray that God would work and do what he wants to do in every venue that I go to. Secondly, we're going to take up an offering this evening. We're going to take up a missionary offering, which, when the basket comes round, seek the Lord. Don't just dump anything in there. Seek the Lord about the amount that he would want you to put in. Remember, we are being partners with the missionaries that we will help from this conference Let's pray before we take up the offering this evening. Father, we do want to thank you that, Lord, we've been able to share experiences of how you have partnered with us. Lord, we thank you for that partnership, that you hold our hand, you walk beside us, you walk with us. And Lord, indeed, we thank you for that. Now, Lord, as we come to this offering, we ask you, Lord, to put upon our hearts what you want us to give. Not what we want to, but what you want to, Lord. That, Father, we may indeed be real partners with those that the finance will go to. And Father, we would give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Right?